Hey guys, here for another species spotlight. We're doing Chinese cave geckos today. They are nocturnal, they're very cryptic, and this is really bright. So I brought over the new enclosure that we just set up for him. And I was only gonna have him out just for this little intro, so it's okay. We're just gonna leave him alone and he can just hang out here because this is already super stressful enough as is because it's so bright and stuff. Chinese cave geckos are a fairly uncommon gecko that we have here in the hobby. They're not necessarily rare, and they've been around for quite a while. There's even quite a few different species of them. Generally, the most common is this Chinese cave gecko here, and then there's also a Japanese cave gecko, but there's a lot of other ones that are around, but this is the most common species. I'm totally spacing on it right now. We'll throw it up here in a second. These guys are really cool, as is in their name. They're from China. They're from cave. They're in caves, and so that's where they spend all of their time. They're strictly nocturnal. These guys make really cool pets because their care is super simple. They don't need UVB because they're strictly nocturnal. They eat insects. They'll eat kind of everything. He eats mostly geckos and crickets and mealworms, not geckos. Like I said before, their care is really simple. They like it humid, they like it dark, and they like it quiet. They also need to be a little bit cooler. So day, like room temperatures, like you would keep a Cresta gecko, like mid 70s, nothing above 80, is perfect for these guys. I think they make really good pets, beginner pets. If it's an animal that you necessarily aren't going to handle a lot, you can just kind of appreciate what they are because they don't really like to be handled, but their care and maintenance is very, very easy. And they just look really cool. Like, you can't really pick them up a whole lot, but they're really cool. They're these, like, kind of dark gray, purplish-black little lizards with these bright white to yellow bands that go across them. And like I said, there's some different patterns and stuff like that. And they have these bright, bright red eyes. So they look like a miniature, small little leopard gecko. They're built kind of the same way. And I mean, they're kind of in close proximity. Like leopard geckos are more kind of like Middle East, Eastern India, and these guys are more like Southern China, Southwestern China. But they're like I said, there's a whole bunch of them that kind of stretch all over the place. But these guys are really cool, really easy little pets. Hopefully, we can get some good shots of these guys, this little guy in here, and maybe we can even get a few more as time goes on. A 10 to 20 gallon tank, I think, is good for these guys. He cruises around a lot at night, and so that's why I bumped him up to this 20 gallon. He was in a 10 for a while as he was just kind of getting acclimated to our gecko cool humid room. And he was doing a really good job, so I decided to put him in here. This isn't a bioactive setup, it's a pretty naturalistic one. So a couple fake plants, rocks, hide. There's this cork bark here that is pressed up against the back, and there's some sphagnum moss back here for extra humidity. And there's just a really thick layer of substrate to help in hold humidity as well. And then just a really big water dish because they all still need fresh water. And I put a little rock in here for crickets to crawl out into. And as I was pulling it out here, I should have dumped it out. I got a bunch of substrate in the water, so I have to change that as soon as we're done with this. But any hoozle bee, this is a really cool gecko species. I think that they're fairly uncommon, but I think they're going to start to get a little bit more popular. I feel like a lot of people, there's a bit of a shift kind of going a little bit in the reptile community where people are going to start getting back into just keeping reptiles instead of strictly breeding them, although breeding them is fairly easy as well, probably about the same as breeding leopard geckos. But I think they're a cool little guy. They look different than, like, their coloration is so much different than leopard geckos. Their build is basically the same, though, so easy to keep, small. Just don't get them really hot and keep them really moist. So other than that, you're good to go. Any hoozle bee, I hope you guys like that. Please like and subscribe if you can. Share with your friends. Hopefully these are like just a quick little thing to, you know, keep you distracted a little bit or something to occupy your time while everyone's just kind of, you know, staying at home, keeping everybody safe, everything like that. And I will catch you next time.